We can run the project. You can see that the app has crashed. We'll check the logcat to see what were the errors. You can see here that missing internet permission. So we'll need to add the internet permission in the Android manifest file. Now run. Now that we have added the internet permission in the Android manifest file, you can run the project again. We can see the success message right over here. So the app has successfully run and the response was hopefully passed. Now we'll need to save the JSON array response into an array list. So create an array list. The type of the array list can be made as scarce model. Go inside the on response method in the retrofit network call callbacks. Now save the responses that we get from the network call into the array list that we just created. We can add a breakpoint in the onResponse method and then again run the project in debug mode so that we can catch the responses right away. Click OK. Now we can see that the breakpoint has landed on the cars, on the breakpoints that we have set on cars model array list. So click skip this step. So now we have the cars model. We can see that the size of the array list cars model is now 6. And all the JSON array contents has been successfully passed into the array list. Now we'll see how to pass this array list into a recycler view.